Welcome back. Today I have more Halloween projects. These have a sort of Victorian Gothic witch vibe to them and are made using mostly Dollar Tree supplies, as usual. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. And if you're new here, hi, I'm Faith, and this is Willoughby DIY. We're starting off with the custom hand towels. Grab you some of these Dollar Tree hand towels. I'm making two, so I got two of the black ones and some ribbon, also from the Dollar Tree. I lucked out with this one, but the other one is just from Dollar Tree. Also grabbed some black and white twine that I picked up at the Dollar Tree as well. We're just going to remove our tags. You could start adding your ribbon. So I'm taking my wide ribbon first, and I'm just going to glue it down 2 inches from the bottom to try to cover up that low pile section of the hand towel. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about, but it's the part that's flat and decorative sort of, but I'm covering that up with the ribbon. Make sure your ribbon overhangs a little bit so it can be wrapped around in the end. Then we're just going to secure the edges down with a little more hot glue so it all lays flat, and then take our accent ribbon, which I'm using this sheer purple sparkly ribbon from the Dollar Tree, and I'm just going to put that right down the middle of my wide ribbon using hot glue, but not too much because it's sheer and the glue will pop through and look terrible, so be careful with that. Take you a couple strands of that twine and we're going to glue that right up against the wide ribbon just to border it and add a little more detail. Once you have those added, you can trim up your ribbon and then flip your towel over and we'll start hot gluing that to the back of the hand towel. I made a second one, and that's really it for these. These are so simple and they look so cute. Next up is my favorite, the ladies and gentlemen sign. I'm going to grab you a couple of those plaques from the Dollar Tree. I picked these two because they're super fancy, and I printed some images from online. I'll link those in the description box for you guys if you want to use the same ones. Remove their labels and give them a good sanding because they have a lot of rough spots here and there. Starting off with a medium grit on my sanding sponge, I'm just going to remove those rough spots and then flip it over to the fine grit side and smooth everything out. Dust it off, and then we can paint. So I'm just going to take this Rust-Oleum linen white chalk paint. You can use whatever white paint you want, or even whatever color you want. We're just painting that front flat face of the plaques. If some paint comes down the side, that's okay. We're painting this black, but I wipe the paint off so there would be no like paint drips and texture. While those dry, you can go ahead and cut out your images. I'm using these little tiny detail scissors from the Dollar Tree, and these are so perfect for projects like this. Now, for most of these images, you don't have to get right up against the picture itself, but for the brims of the hats, you do want to, because they will be overlapping your skulls and you don't want that extra white space. Everything else you can kind of go around in a general way, especially the florals on the lady's hat. That would be a serious pain to cut out super detailed. Cut out your skulls. And for these, I do leave like a millimeter of white space on the outside of the skull image, just because later I'm going in with a black marker to darken that up. For one, I left it completely whole, but for the lady, I wanted her to look a little more feminine and a bit different than the gentleman's skull, so I'm removing the mandible. And I think it does look a bit more feminine. I use spray adhesive to attach these to begin with. I do recommend you use Mod Podge though. This didn't work out. I just wanted to see if it would work, and it wasn't that great. Maybe if it was a better spray adhesive, I don't know. But attach your skulls and your hats to your plaques, and then we can start detailing the plaques. I went in with a black on the outside edge of these, just giving one good coat all the way around, trying to get neatly up against the white part of the plaque, but 4 cups of coffee and no food. I'm pretty jittery at this point. But it worked out because I got some on the front face of it and it looked distressed. So I just kind of ran with it and distressed the entire front of the plaque itself. Not the images, just the plaque. Once that dried, I went in with my fine tip black marker and broadened that outline of the skulls just to make them pop. And I think it looked so much better than it did originally. And then I'm taking some metallic gold paint and painting in that little tiny crevice around the entire plaque, and then let it dry and Mod Podge them. Once the Mod Podge is dry, we can create something to hang it with. I'm using that same ribbon from the hand towels, and I'm just going to create a bow with the black and white ribbon You've seen me make these little bows. They're like little bow tie pastas. Yeah, I'm not really great at ribbons, so just make your own pretty little bow. I wanted this to look kind of like a bow tie because, you know, the gentleman. Anyway, after I made the bow, it's the bow shape, I took about a three-inch piece of that same ribbon, cut it in half lengthwise, and wrapped around the center of my bow. And to create a hanger, I took some white wire, made a loop, twisted the ends, formed it around the center of my bow, and then hot glued that on. For extra security, I took the purple ribbon and I just hot glued it and wrapped it around either side of that wire on the center of the bow. Now you want to take three pieces of each ribbon. These measurements you see on the screen are what you want. Put the accent ribbon straight down the center of the wide ribbon. For the bottom ribbon, we want to dovetail it. I use a flame to melt the edges of the ribbon so it doesn't fray. We're going to hot glue the bow to the top. Then we're going to line up our plaque the way we want. I have the lady on the top, gentleman on the bottom. Flip them over, keep them lined up, and start adding our ribbons. I'm using a combination of staples and some hot glue on the corners to keep them in place. We're going to use that short ribbon for the middle of the plaques, and then we have our dovetail on the end and our bow on the top. And that's really it for these guys. You see here, the ribbons are shorter than they were when I was making it. I gave you the measurements of what you see here, not what the process was showing. So the ribbons need to be shorter. Just know that. Next up is the simple wood tray. I made it very complicated. Wish I hadn't. You need two of these trays from the Dollar Tree. Remove one end of them. And that's super easy. Just pull it off carefully. We're going to reinforce the bottom of both trays with some hot glue, putting it right in that seam you see me doing here. We're going to take some wood glue and we're going to push these two trays together. Now there will be a gap. If you want, you can cut those little excess pieces off and glue it that way, but everyone was asleep and I didn't want to use my Dremel and wake everyone up, so I'm doing it the hard way. We're going to clip it in place so it holds properly and dries properly. Of course, I didn't wait for it to dry to move on. Please do that. That's what caused me issues. This is a large craft stick cut to fit the bottom of the tray, and I'm adding wood glue and hot glue. I'm going to hold it up so it doesn't touch the tray and slide it over that gap. I know, I should have just let the tray dry. Would have saved me a lot of trouble. Once that piece is on, you can reinforce with a little more hot glue. I decided to put some stainable wood filler in that gap there. It's filled all of these cracks and crevices so it would look like a solid tray. Let it dry, sanded it smooth, and it had cracks. I noticed them before I started sanding, but I had to sand it smooth anyway. So this is what caused me to not be able to stain it, because I had to go back in with all this wood glue and let it fully adhere and dry together. So I just used burnt umber acrylic paint and a wet paintbrush to smooth that paint all over, wipe the excess off with a paper towel, and just do a paint stain basically all over this tray, which I like, but I think dark walnut would have been nicer. Just saying. You could still see where the glue was and the filler was, so I just took some undiluted burnt umber, put it in the most discolored spot of the tray, and then feathered out the edges, if that makes sense, to cover that up. I decorate it, and I'll show you that here in just a second, but I do love this tray. It reminds me of one I seen on the show, The Irregulars. It was a scene with Dr. Watson, and I seen this tray that had like some little bottles, and it was like a drop-off station. One of the decorations for the tray is a cloche, but I'm going to show you how to make two of these. So you're going to want two of the cloches from the Dollar Tree. For one of them, I'm going to use these gemstones. Clean your cloches with some alcohol first so you don't have any trouble with adhesion. This one, I'm just going to take these strips of rhinestones and put them right around the center of that base. For the second one, I'm going to take these ones and do sort of a zigzaggy pattern. So I cut them before I take them off and attach them to the base. You can see I'm cutting every two and then removing the excess bit of adhesive strip as well. Then I'm just going to pull them off and stick them onto my base in a slanted way so that they go up and down, like zigzags. I don't know. Does that make sense? Can you tell? Once they're done, you want to grab yourself a couple of buttons to put on the tops of our cloches. These I got from Michaels. And then we're going to spray paint the bases and those little buttons or handles. They will be handles now with this soft flat iron. Let it dry. And to just add a bit more distressed, detailed look to it, I take this brushed silver paint and give it a dry brushing all over. And that's on the bases and those little button handle thingies. Once that's dry, we can attach our little buttons to the tops of our cloches. Put you an even amount of glue around that hole on these buttons. Flip your cloche over so you can look through the top of it and line the hole on the button up with that dot at the top of the cloche. Then you can decorate them with whatever you want. I'm going to show you a couple of things I customized. I used this pitiful little bird who has seen much better days. I removed what was left of his feathers, cleaned him up, and then painted him black. And then I detailed on his beak, feet, and his eyes with some silver paint. You can also see how I created a wing look with hot glue on the sides of his body. For the other one, I customized this apple that was on this pick. I just pulled it off, removed its stem, painted the stem silver, the apple black, let him dry, and reattached the stem using hot glue. I used some florals, some berries, Spanish moss, just different stuff for these two cloches. I can't decide which one I like better, so let me know which one you like better in the comments. This witchy book stack I created for the tray as well. You just need one of the Dollar Tree crates. For the top book, we're going to paint it this purple pansy color. And I give these at least two coats. Some get more paint because I mess up and have to repaint it, like paint over things. I'm also going to paint what was the bottom to be the top of the purple book. The bottom book will be this flamenco red. It's a beautiful, deep, dark red color. I love it. And the middle one will be this marsh green. If you can't tell, these are Sanderson sister colors because I had to have a nod to Hocus Pocus somewhere in my Halloween decor because it is one of my favorite movies. And me and my husband and our two girls, we watch it every year after we go trick-or-treating. Once you have your books painted, we can move on to customizing them. For each book, I do a different binding design on them using these metallic markers from the Dollar Tree. For the purple one, I'm doing it with a gold color marker. And what you see me doing here, I will change later, but that's fine. I also detail here and there on some of them with a black Sharpie. And use a ruler to get nice straight lines if you need to. Like this is the front of the book and I'm just giving it like that little binding part on the side with some gold paint so I don't mess up my marker. For the green book, we're using silver. And I even sort of detailed the sides or the top and bottoms of the quote unquote books, giving them a little different shape and pattern to them. It's not necessary, but I wanted to do it. For the red book, I'm using a rose gold metallic marker, and I do kind of lightly outline all of the books just so it doesn't look so plain, you know. Once all that's done, I take this black brush tip marker that's actually for glass, but I'm going to fill in those little crevices between the books. Just darken them up, they don't have to be perfect, and use a Sharpie and a ruler to put your lines on the sides. It's mostly done at this point. Now you just need to add the details. So for the red book, I'm going to add this cute little rub-on transfer of a potion bottle from one rub-on transfer from the Dollar Tree. And then I'm taking the white metallic marker from the Dollar Tree, which isn't metallic, by the way. It's just a white paint marker, basically. And writing potions, poisons on it. For the green book, we're going to take a different rub-on transfer sheet from the Dollar Tree and take this crystal ball and put it on there. Now the red book can be read horizontally, but the green book will be read vertically. And we're gonna write divination with a black Sharpie down the side. I had to do this twice because I messed up the first time. No, three times. I messed up the first two times and had to paint over it twice. But I finally got there, and for I'm going to take this rub-on transfer sheet, also from the Dollar Tree, and I'm going to cut out this little decorative bit here and attach it to the side of our purple book, outline it with the gold marker. And on the front of it, I'm going to use this little triangle decorative piece that kind of matches that rectangular one and attach it to the front of the book, outlining again with the gold marker. For extra detail, I'm going to take the rub-on transfer sheet where we had the crystal ball from. I'm going to take the moon off of it and add it to the center of our purple book. This is the second time I'm writing spells and incantations, because the first time I misspelled incantations. But that's okay. I gave it 2 coats of paint, covered it up, wait for it to dry, and then did this. And I kind of messed up the end of incantations. It's all smushed and messed up, but it's fine. I went with it. I detailed it a bit with that gold marker. And I also didn't want to cover this in ribbon, so I traced some pieces of cardboard, stuck them in those holes, and hot glued them from the inside. And then I'm just going to paint over those with my paints, just the paints where it's what it's supposed to be, the red and green. And then after that dries, using the markers to finish those lines. And that's really it for this witchy book stack. And here you can see the complete look for my tray. I've got some Dollar Tree dry florals and a Dollar Tree vase I just picked up, and one of those cloches on top of a Goodwill brass goblet just to raise it up a bit. It's gorgeous. Now we've got the shelf decor. First up is our gilded skeleton, using this glow-in-the-dark skeleton from the Dollar Tree. Disassemble him, okay? And then reassemble using hot glue to hold him in whatever position you want. I want mine to be sitting on a shelf with his legs dangling in a more natural-looking way than if I was to just sit him on there. So we're bending the knees and making the feet hang more naturally. And I want his head to be turned to the side. Once he's all reassembled, you can spray paint him. I used this almond satin spray paint by Rust-Oleum. Gave him 2 coats, let him dry, and then we're going to add some details with some gold metallic paint. I did take a fluffier brush and just kind of feather out some spots of the paint, just to give him a more shiny look, a more gold distressed look. And then once he dried, I took more gold paint and darkened up like the joints and the sternum and the eye sockets, that sort of thing, to give him more gold look. The simple floral one, it's barely even worth my time putting in here, but I had to, because you could just take simple things from Goodwill, like this little cup, add some floral foam, like these blooming branches without their leaves, and some Spanish moss, and you got a Halloween floral arrangement. I'm also going to take this little picture frame from Goodwill, some of this scrapbooking paper, this rub-on transfer sheet, I'm grabbing that haunted house, and we're going to make an image for this little frame. And then I just distressed the frame with a sanding sponge to make it look older and less gold, and that's it. We have a simple candle hack here as well. But grab any candle. I grabbed this one from Target, flip it around to the back, and I'm going to take a rub-on transfer and attach it to the jar. And then I take an X-Acto knife, distress the sides to hide the fact that I put it on crooked and to make it look older. You have a customized candle for Halloween or whenever. Then you need a shelf to put all these cool things on, so I grabbed this $5 Target shelf. I could only find it in white, but I didn't want it to be white, and I didn't want it to be black either, so I took some antiquing wax and just coated the entire thing. So I painted it on the wax, rubbed it off with a paper towel, and that was it for the shelf. Then you could just hang it on your wall. I put mine in my bathroom and then put all the neat little things I just made onto it, including my skeleton, which is held up there using some double-sided like tape thingies, like the little foam ones. I forgot what they're called. And I also added some of my potion bottles, well, ingredient bottles that we made in last week's video. So if you haven't seen that yet, check that out. I'll link that at the end, but I love the shelf and all the things on it. It is so beautiful. My favorite project of all of these is the Ladies and Gentlemen sign, but let me know which one is yours in the comments down below. And if you enjoyed this video, leave a like. Maybe consider subscribing if you haven't already. Tap that notification bell so you know every time I upload. And I hope you all have a spectacularly spooky day. Bye. I'll see you guys next time.